T-Rex arms were small and weak. So, T-Rex arms pretty tiny, right? That might be in comparison to the body, but the Tyrannosaurus did have quite a lot of use for its arms. It is believed, or dare I say confirmed, that they were very muscular. They could be used to grapple or wound prey, or help the T-Rex get up from a resting position, or hold on to the mate during mating. If you want the perspective, their arms were 3 times more powerful than human arms, so you could actually imagine a T-Rex bench pressing like 190 kilograms on each arm. Moving on to myth number 2. Don't move, its sight is based on movement. That is a line I am way too familiar with as a huge Jurassic Park fan. However, if you would ever find yourself eye to an eye with a T-Rex, you either pray that it's not hungry, or you run into some area where it would be hard for it to follow you. The T-Rex, just as many other theropods, had a great eyesight for hunting prey, and their binocular range was around 55 degrees, which is greater than a hawk. Now, you know the saying, eyesight like a hawk. Or maybe that's just something we say in Sweden, but to say the least, the Tyrannosaurus Rex did not need glasses. Myth number 3. The T-Rex had feathers. Well, this one is both wrong and correct at the same time. Let me explain it to you. Now, it is hard to say it, but something Jurassic Park did get right, kind of, I'll touch more on that soon, is that the T-Rex was one big scaly, scary looking animal. Although several finds of Tyrannosauroids showing proto-feathers or fossilized feather fibers, nothing have been found on the older Tyrannosaurus rexes themselves. So, a giant walking chicken, sorry guys, did not exist. It is however believed that younger T-Rex, mostly hatchlings, had feathers to help them keep warm, and that they later shed them as they grew older. Just a quick note, Tyrannosauroids are not Tyrannosaurus rex, they do however belong in the same family. Moving on to number 4, teeth outside of the mouth. Now, we see a lot of depictions of the Tyrannosaurus having big sharp teeth visible outside of the mouth. However, this wouldn't be practical work because teeth need to be lubricated in one way or another, which for land animals and on us humans, they're hidden inside of our mouths, you know, sealed by the lips. If they go too dry, there will soon be many related issues and holes would be formed, which in turn would be very painful, basically a rotten mess. Now, this works on sharks and crocodiles because naturally the water helps their teeth to not become too dry. On the T-Rex, however, it had lips covering its teeth to stay protected. So all these cool shots showing teeth outside of the mouth, not practical, wasn't a thing. Moving on to number 5, the T-Rex fought the Spinosaurus. Now, the reason why I bring this up is because there are still many people that believe this because of Jurassic Park. Let's look at the numbers, shall we? The Tyrannosaurus lived at the very end of the Cretaceous period, between 68 to 65 million years ago. The Spinosaurus lived around 112 to 93 million years ago. Do you see the difference? Now, however, a fight that could have actually did happen would be the Spinosaurus versus the Carcharodontosaurus. But more on that, I shall touch upon in another video. Have a good one, guys.